Hi my dears, welcome back to the maths class. In the last class, we learned the units to measure liquid objects. Let's start today's session. Today's first activity, 1 liter. How many times each measuring jar is to be used to fill a 1 liter vessel? Children, see this table. First measuring jar, 1 liter. Children, how many times do you use a 1 liter jar to fill a 1 liter vessel? Yes, one time. Children, see the next one. How many times do you use a 500 milliliter jar to fill a 1 liter vessel? Children, you know, 1 liter equals 1000 milliliters. Children, how many 500 milliliters make 1000 milliliters? Yes, 2 500 milliliters make 1000 milliliters. That is 500 milliliters plus 500 milliliters equals 1000 milliliters. That is 2 times 500 milliliters make 1000 milliliters. So children, when a 500 milliliter jar is used 2 times, the 1 liter vessel fills up. Like that, how many times do you use a 200 milliliter jar to fill a 1 liter vessel? Listen children, how many 200 milliliters make 1000 milliliters? Yes, 5 200 milliliters make 1000 milliliters. That is 200 milliliters plus 200 milliliters plus 200 milliliters plus 200 milliliters plus 200 milliliters equals 1000 milliliters. That is 5 times 200 milliliters make 1000 milliliters. So children, when a 200 milliliter jar is used 5 times, the 1 liter vessel fills up. Children, see the next one. How many times do you use a 100 milliliter jar to fill a 1 liter vessel? Children, how many times 100 milliliters make 1000 milliliters? Yes, 10 times 100 milliliters make 1000 milliliters. So children, when a 100 milliliter jar is used 10 times, the 1 liter vessel fills up. Children, see the next one. How many times do you use a 50 milliliter jar to fill a 1 liter vessel? Listen children, how many 50 milliliters make 1000 milliliters? Yes, 20 50 milliliters make 1000 milliliters. So children, when a 50 milliliter jar is used 20 times, the 1 liter vessel fills up. Children, see the next activity. How many times using 500, 200 and 100 milliliter measuring jars, what are the possible ways of filling a 1 liter can? Children, here we have to find out the possible ways of filling a 1 liter vessel using 500, 200 and 100 milliliter measuring jars. Children, you remember one thing, we can use only 500, 200 and 100 milliliter measuring jars. One is given for you, that is 1 500 milliliters, 2 200 milliliters, 100 milliliters. That is when 1 500 milliliters, 2 200 milliliters and 100 milliliters add together, we get 1000 milliliters, which is equal to 1 liter. Like this, can you find out the other possibility? Yes, when 3 200 milliliters and 400 milliliters add together, we get 1000 milliliters, which is equal to 1 liter. So, we can say that 3 200 milliliters and 400 milliliters make 1 liter. Children, let's see another possibility. When 1 500 milliliters, 1 200 milliliters and 300 milliliters add together, we get 1000 milliliters, which is equal to 1 liter. So, we can say that 1 500 milliliters, 1 200 milliliters and 300 milliliters make 1 liter. Children, let's see another possibility. When 1 500 milliliters and 500 milliliters add together, we get 1000 milliliters, which is equal to 1 liter. So, we can say that 1 500 milliliters and 500 milliliters make 1 liter. Like this, can you fill a 2 liter can in different ways? You should do this activity in your rough note. Children, listen to the next question. How many liters? There was 2 liters and 500 milliliters of coconut oil in the shop. Today, 6 liters and 750 milliliters of coconut oil was added. How much coconut oil does the shop have now? Children, listen to the question once again. How much coconut oil was there in the shop? Yes, 2 liters and 500 milliliters. So, quantity of coconut oil that was in the shop is equal to? Yes, 2 liters, 500 milliliters. Children, how much oil was added today? Yes, 6 liters and 750 milliliters. So, quantity of coconut oil added today is equal to? Yes, 6 liters, 750 milliliters. Children, listen to the question. How much coconut oil does the shop have now? That means we have to find out the total quantity of coconut oil. To find the total quantity of coconut oil, add 2 liters 500 milliliters and 6 liters 750 milliliters together. So, total quantity of coconut oil is equal to 2 liters 500 milliliters plus 6 liters 750 milliliters. To solve this, arrange liters and milliliters as shown here. Then write 2 below the liter and 500 below the milliliter and 6 below the liter and 750 below the milliliter. Then add together 0 plus 0, 0, 5 plus 0, 5, 7 plus 5, 12. Write 2 here, 1 carry over. 6 plus 2, 8, 8 plus 1, 9. So, total quantity of coconut oil is equal to 9 liters, 250 milliliters. Children, did you understand today's session? Okay, it is the time to wind up today's class. Thank you.